Carved under the temple of Apollo in Delphi, ancient Greece, Socrates decided to steal and run with the phrase of know thyself. He famously said, "To know thyself is the beginning of all knowledge." Many scholars argue on Socrates' view on self-knowledge, as for the soul or the self being constantly changing, so how can you actually truly know yourself? And the one we're going to look at today, which is interconnected with the academic Emma McGabe's view, in which she states, "To know thyself requires, quote, the courage to persevere, to acknowledge failure, to live with the knowledge of one's own ignorance." So introspection and self-examination, basically. But before any of this, there is one common problem amongst a lot of people, which is why it's common, I don't know why I said common. Anyways, the common problem is distraction. Distraction and not allowing yourself to just think on your own, and not allowing boredom to just allow itself to do its thing. And boredom is not a bad thing, because it just allows you to sit there with your own thoughts. And a lot of people just don't really want to do that nowadays, as it is understandable, because there's literally all the entertainment you can get, anyone you can talk to, basically anyone you know you can talk to, all the information, every single choice out there on the palm of your hands. There's just everything on the palm of your hands, basically, and that would make for a pretty good distraction, and one that I'd fall to quite often. And still do, still very much do. So with all the choice, all the information, all the things you can do, it's very easy to just not allow yourself to be bored and sit with your own thoughts. And that's bad, because, I mean, you kind of need that to know yourself and dive into yourself and self-examine. One of the best advice, Hamza, a self-improvement YouTuber, which I'm pretty sure you'd know if you're watching this video, kind of inspired me to do this whole thing. One of his best advice was just to stare and sit in front of a wall, and you'd actually be really surprised what the insight you can have from that simple exercise, and also be pretty shocked to find out how difficult it is to just sit there and just sit and stare at a wall. Pretty hard to do, surprisingly. But think of any great pioneer, musician, philosopher, scientist, anyone who's changed the world in some way. They've all spent a great deal of time in solitude and with their own thoughts, and I guess that was a very necessary part for them to excel at whatever they were doing. This is a path inward and knowing your present self, which is going to be step number one. For this, I want you to do an exercise, and it's just going to be to think about these questions, to be honest. What values / beliefs do you have? How do you view yourself? Confident, shy, hardworking, whatever characteristics you have, and where are you in life at this present moment? List every single characteristic you know about yourself. And after this video, actually genuinely do this exercise, or right now actually, write it down and really just sit and think on it for a while and be like, what am I actually like? Like, what do I know about myself? What's my identity? Like, what is me? And this is like a life-changing exercise if you can do it. I'm not exaggerating that. This can be life-changing, because it's going to start the journey inward and to actually know yourself. Like, knowing yourself is such a foundational thing, right? It comes before anything you do. Like, you have to have an idea of yourself. And for the next part, I want you to question why. Why are you like this for all those characteristics? This will start on knowing your past self. The people you spent with, the people you watched online, the events that you went through. All of these made you the person you are today. And of course, there's a genetic element. I think it's like half and half, if I'm just going off the top of my head. But this video is going to be on what you can control, and I don't think you can really control your genes just about yet, but you can control, going back into your memories and introspecting, right? So I'll give you quite a recent personal example. This is very recent, a couple of days ago. And it starts off with me being always a bit weird on expressing my feelings and just self-expression in general. This whole YouTube thing's helping a lot, by the way, but I've always had a really hard time, like, this exact thing of, like, expressing how I feel, expressing who I am, just kind of, like, putting up this, like, curtain whenever I meet with new people. I don't really show my true self. I don't show how I feel that much. I don't really share that much. I don't really self-express as much, especially in social situations with meeting new people and stuff. I'm not really good at that at all. I have a really bad ability to do that. But as a toddler or a kid, I was quite the opposite. I was a bundle of joy from all the videos I can let you watch of myself, from my family. Like, they always say, like, I was so happy all the time. I talked a lot, I was really energetic, and those are things that don't sound like a person that can't express themselves well. It sounds like the opposite, actually. So after a certain point, I developed this anxiety. I became really introverted. I didn't really have that ability to get to know and talk to new people. I always was anxious, and I was just like, like, why? I never actually questioned it, and I mentioned it so many times in all my videos. And it kind of just hit me a couple of days ago with a certain event, and I always shrugged this event off. I never really think about it too much, and to be honest, I don't really, it's something that I just repressed a lot in the back of my mind, and it's something that I don't show that much emotion to, and I didn't up until that point where I kind of got hit with it. And you know, after actually looking through it, that event was the miscarriage of my little brother. And to give some context, you know, I was pretty lonely whenever I came to the UK. I came to the UK when I was like three years old, moving from Bangladesh. There weren't really kids my age that my family friends, like, they didn't have kids my age. I didn't really get to play with many people, or maybe, actually no, I was in nursery, but didn't understand a word of English, as you'd expect. But so yeah, I don't think I made that many friends. I can't really remember, to be honest, but basically I was just a bit lonely. I didn't really have anyone to play with. And when I heard that I was getting a little brother, I was like ecstatic. I was like, oh my God, it's gonna be someone exactly like me. And I've always wanted that, like, younger brother. I thought it was something that I'd really like to have, and I would have, obviously. And when I did get the news, I knew my mother was pretty sick for a while. Pretty sure I understood what was happening. I was like nine, I think I was nine when it was happening. When I did actually get to the news, I didn't really think of it too much. I don't actually remember that much of it. I have like glimpses from my memory, but I'm pretty certain I knew what happened, but I just repressed it. I repressed a lot of it. Whenever I did think back to that event, I was just like, oh, no emotion, stone cold. I just repressed. I didn't really show that much emotion. I was just like, oh. And I think what happened was that since it was such a big loss, my brain just coped by repressing it. And I became quite anxious that it could happen again if I met new people and talked to them and had high hopes, like having friends again. But and for whatever reason, caused a lot of anxiety, caused me to become a lot more shelled in and not just express myself. I was a lot more anxious to express myself after that. And you know, it's not like the biggest like trauma in existence, right? I grew up pretty comfortably. My parents worked really hard for me to have a roof over my head, have food on the table, blah blah blah, right? This isn't the sob story, but I'm just sharing a trauma that did affect me, and especially to this day, and something that I didn't really catch on till a couple of days ago at the very least. And that's probably because I know it's because leaving Belfast to uni. So it's that feeling of loss again, with all my friends and such relationships, platonic ones, obviously, no romantic ones, obviously. I wouldn't lose them. I wouldn't be losing them. But yeah, actually understanding that it was this all along, and it was such a eureka moment. I was just like, oh, this makes so much sense. I always shrugged that memory off. I never really sat down and thought through it because it was really uncomfortable. It was really uncomfortable to just think through that again. But once I did, it was really satisfying, and I got to know who I truly am, and it was pretty freeing. I feel a lot more free now. I'm just like, oh, that's why it happened. I now just have the understanding. It's like you're right. It's your right to have that knowledge, right? Journaling is the best way to introspect, in my opinion. Like, if you ever get like notions in your head of these like lucid thoughts, and to actually just write it down, writing it down, and what it does is, whenever you do write down your thoughts and the notions in your head, it puts it down into something coherent, because language is in itself coherent. It's got a structure. It forces it to have a certain logic to it, which is what coherent means, I think. Consistent, logical ways to actually put down your thoughts, and it's very, very powerful. I highly recommend you do it. After this video, you better be doing it. And so, I recommend you do it with the topic of, well, yourself, who are you, right? That can be like the main topic of the video, and what you really are. So what you are, and then the why you are, and then the whither. And I had to search this up and it means to what place. So the what, the why, and the whither. To what place? So present, past, and future. So what, to what place are you going to go with this? You know, what's the projection of your life at the minute? How do you view your current self to go in 5-10 years? For most men nowadays, not the best, and even myself, which is why I always aim to get better. You know, my current projection, I might do well, but like, I'm not gonna excel. So I'm always just trying to aim to get better, you know, that lifelong student kind of mindset, which is you're just trying to get better step by step, small step by step. You can't do it overnight. Ultimately, it's not the past or future that's most important, but what you do now. You know, what are you gonna do? Are you actually gonna do the things that are recommended? And if you do them, what are you gonna do next? Are you just gonna whine and complain that you are this way? Or try and work on it. Try and actually solve the problems that you have with your life. And I don't know the problems that you do have in your life, with a topic so personal as it can get, kind of, as yourself. You're gonna have to find out this one on your own. You know, I can't like name every single scenario in ever and like give you solutions to them. You're gonna have to do this yourself. I'm just gonna give you the tools and the mental exercises to actually allow yourself to go out and do them. Knowing thyself is such a foundational thing. Knowing what you are at this current present moment, knowing why you are this way, and knowing what you're gonna do about it. If you ever get challenged, fail, win, whatever life throws at you, the knowledge of yourself will be of utmost importance. Your identity is at the base of anything. And to end this off, because I think this is a good place to end it, with Socrates and his demise. Accused of corrupting the youth by Melitus, sentenced to execution by a lethal dose of hemlock, cheerfully and calmly, he drank the poison handed to him by a soldier. When the men around him started to cry, he became disappointed, as this was the reason he sent away the women from the room. In a recount by Plato's Phaedo, "What are you all doing? I am so surprised at you. I had sent away the women mainly because I did not want them to lose control in this way. You see, I have heard that a man should come to his end in a way that calls for measured speaking. So you must have composure and you must endure." Even at Socrates' death, he stuck to his belief and views. As always, from hate to love.